everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of AGP Unboxed. This is a really special episode. I've got a special treat for you guys and for myself as well. You see, today's my birthday. Well, by the time you guys see this, it's not my birthday anymore, but it was my birthday. And I've got something here that I purchased and sort of forgot about. Months and months and months ago, I was on eBay, like I tend to be on the lot, and I happened to be looking for something in particular, found it, and I found it at a very reduced cost as opposed to what other sellers were selling the same item for. And whenever I find that, I always tend to go look at the other auctions offered by that same seller, because the odds are pretty good if they have something else that I might be interested in, it's probably also going to be offered at a reduced cost compared to everyone else. And so in looking at this person's other auctions, I found this Scars of Mirrodin Fat Pack here for Magic the Gathering. Now, Scars of Mirrodin is one of those sets that I missed during my hiatus away from Magic the Gathering. Sometime between that Weatherlight / Stronghold set got released back in, I don't know, 2001, 2, 3, something like that. I don't know, may have even been late 90s, I'm not real sure. All the way up through Theros back in 2012, 13-ish, maybe 11. I can't remember when Theros was released. Big gap there. And one of the sets that I missed, like I said, was Scars of Mirrodin. And the seller had this thing up there for like $35, maybe $40. I can't remember exactly what the cost of it was. But the normal price on these things, I went to look at some of the other versions on eBay that are up for buy it now price. And most of them are selling for like either $59 or $69 at buy it now. So it's about a $20 savings. And I thought, you know what? I've never gotten any Scars of Mirrodin stuff before. It's not one of the sets that I'm currently working on collecting. Although, at some point, I definitely want to get into it because, as I've said several times, one of my goals is to, at some point, get a copy of every Magic card produced. And I'd really like to open those copies from booster packs and booster boxes. I thought, you know what, it's such a good deal, I'm going to go ahead and pick this thing up. And that way, when I do get around to starting collecting Scars of Mirrodin, it'll be there, and I won't have to go hunting for one. So I picked this thing up, and it's just been sitting in a box for the last month and a half, 2 months now. And to be honest with you, I'd kind of forgotten about it. And so come to a couple of days ago, and I'm thinking, you know, my birthday's coming up, I ought to go buy myself a little something special. And I started thinking about what I might want, and then I thought, you know what? I've got that Scars of Mirrodin box. Why not just open that thing up and see what's inside and give yourself a little birthday treat? And so that's what we're going to do today. We're going to crack ourselves a Scars of Mirrodin Fat Pack. And I'm really excited about this. I've already got shrink wrap off, because let's say, who wants to watch me cut shrink wrap off a box of cards? But I'm really excited about seeing this thing. I can tell you right now, just from the feel of this thing, it feels completely different than the current fat packs and boxes and things. It's a much more textured feel to it. But I don't know, I'm really, really excited about seeing what's in this, seeing what cards I get to pull. I have no idea what cards are even in this set. I haven't looked anything up ahead of time. So I'm going into this completely blind, zero knowledge. I'm really just interested, like I've said many times before, in the artwork of the cards. I love art, and I love seeing just small pieces of artwork that can inspire me in my own art. So, really looking forward to getting into this thing. Scars of Mirrodin Fat Pack. Let's jump over to the table and crack open this thing and see exactly what's inside. All right, so Scars of Mirrodin. I've never opened a Scars of Mirrodin pack in my life, so I'm actually kind of excited about getting into this thing. Taking a look at the contents here. Looks like we get a player's guide, card box with panoramic art, 8 Scars of Mirrodin booster packs, which is kind of interesting. I'm used to seeing 9, and actually now 10 with the bundles. A 40-card basic land pack, and a special edition spend down life counter available only in the fat pack. Well, that's kind of interesting. All right, so let's see what we got here. All right, we've got our card box there. We've got our player's guide here. So let's do this in some semblance of order. All right, so player's guide. Let me get into that in a few minutes, because I have no idea what's even in Scars of Mirrodin. Our panoramic
shot here is on the inside of this. That's actually a pretty cool guy. I don't know who that is offhand. Pretty neat looking dude, though. And then there's a some sort of green critter in there. I'm not going to undo this, by the way. Very large golem type miniature and what appears to be an undead dragon. So several different characters all over this thing. Very, very cool. Set that to the side. And let's take a look inside this player's guide. The feel of this is much, much different. Even the packaging, it's a very it's a textured feel compared to the slick fat packs and bundles that I'm used to opening. This is very it's very grainy feeling actually. So kind of interesting. Even the, like I said, the book here too, is the box actually feels pretty normal, the card holder, but very strange. All right, so let's take a look at this here. See what we've got. All right, so got just sort of a history of the Mirrodin cycle, I suppose. Some neat little artwork. Ah, that must be Koth on the inside of the panoramic poster. That looks like Elspeth. Oh, it is, actually. That would be what reading's for. Oh, okay, here we are. Here's some card pictures of what's in the set. Okay. So, okay, there's that that golem guy, the Platinum Imperion. Interesting. Okay. So, there's that. And then a standard showing of every card in the set, along with some checklist. I see a sword in there. I think I did. Ah, okay, yeah, I know about some of the swords, the Feast and Famine. I don't know if I've ever heard of the Sword of Body and Mind before, but kind of sounds a little familiar. All right, so a little checklist there. Very, very cool. All right, so let's take a look inside the box itself. So let's get the lid off of this. Okay, well, there's something else in here, too. Okay, what is this? Test of Metal. A sample chapter from a Planeswalker novel. Oh, that's kind of interesting. Okay. So, all the books that Wizards has released, this is one chapter from one of the books. I guess Test of Metal would be the name of the book. That's kind of cool. Okay. That's neat. You don't get that in modern-day fat packs and bundles, namely because it doesn't seem that Wizards writes books anymore. All right, so let's set this container to the side. Very nice container, by the way. I really like the... I like that kind of... it's sort of a bluish version of an olive drab. It's a nice background color. I really like it. Very cool. It's kind of scaly, dragony-looking pattern on the top of it. Very neat. All right, so we'll set that to the side as well. And I need a hobby knife. All right. Go ahead and gently get into this. Okay, I'm not quite sure what makes this a special edition spin down. It looks like just a standard blue spin down with the Scars of Mirrodin logo on it. Maybe somebody out there can tell me what makes this a special edition that's only available in the Fat Pack. Maybe not. Who knows? So, well, this is sort of tight plastic, so cut it a little bit more. Okay. Set that to the side. And then, let's see, where do I want to cut here? Let's cut on this player's guide thing. That way I don't damage any of the land or any of the packaging. Because I think the land should be in its, yes, it's in its own little package. That's cool. It's actually a smaller pack of land than I'm used to seeing. I don't have one of the, I think I've got one of the packs currently. I think nowadays you get, I want to say you get 80 land in a bundle or a fat pack. This is only 40. Okay, so this is a guide on how to play. Let me zoom out a little bit. I don't know why I zoomed in quite that much. We're not looking at cards yet. Okay, so it's like a roadmap. All right, there we go. All right, that's that's pretty cool. I like that. Very, very nice. Don't know if it would be useful in learning how to play. I suppose that I could read it. But I like the old rule books that they used to have in the really, really old mid-1990s stuff, revised, 4th edition, that kind of stuff. I like those rule books better. Nice, complete set of, or not necessarily a complete set of rules, but a nice in-depth guide on how to play. So, this is nice, I'm sure, but I still like the rule books. Okay, so, now we come to the crux of the Fat Pack, and that would be the 8 booster packs. Let me put my hobby knife away and see what we've got. Okay, so we've got, let's see here, we've got mostly Elspeth, it looks like, but we'll just kind of go in and let's see here. Well, I tell you what, let's divide it up fairly evenly. How about that? We'll be different. All right, so we got one of this guy, two of this one, and three of this one. So let's take 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, and Elspeth. All right, there we go. So let's start off with this one here. And let's see, am I in a relatively good position? I think that's fine. You can probably read the whole card if I once I get him out of here. So let's set these off to the side and see what is in my very first pack ever of Scars of Mirrodin. All right. For those of you that have never seen me open packs before, first of all, this is not working. Let's go to the bottom of the pack, and hopefully I'll be able to get into it this way. There we go. Okay, the bottom opens fine. Good. Generally speaking, I'm not a huge Magic player. I do like to play Magic every now and again, but mostly what I really enjoy is the artwork. I really just love good pieces of art, and being able to have all of these small pieces of art that I can use for inspiration in my own artwork is always very nice. So it's fun for me just to kind of look at the pictures and things. So, but since this is my first set of Scars of Mirrodin, we're going to go through each card. I'm going to just kind of read off the cards, and then I'll read what the rares and the mythics in the pack actually do. So we have a Sky Eel School, a Silver Mirror, Blade Tribe Berserkers, Nurok Invisimancer, okay, Chrome Steed, that's really, really well done. I love the chrome work on that. That's beautiful. All right. A Nihil Spellbomb, or Nihil, I guess, Nihilistic. That's weird. Why would you, I don't know why you would abbreviate the word, who knows. Dross Hopper. What is that? I don't know what that dude is eating, but it almost looks like he's like peeling some dude's eyeball or eyelid back away from the eyeball. That's really creepy. I don't know what that is. Frightening, though. Melt Terrain. That's a really, really, really nicely done piece of art. I like that. I love the wisps of smoke coming up. Very cool. And then let's see what else we have. Echo Circlet, all right, and Stoic Rebuttal. Ah, okay, so we've got into our uncommons. For those of you that have never opened a pack of Magic cards, the reason I know that is because this symbol here, the set symbol, has changed from black and white to a silver color. When we get to the rare, it'll change to either gold if it's a rare, or if it's a really rare card called a Mythic Rare, it will be a reddish-orange sort of color. Volition Reigns is our first uncommon. Embersmith. Ah, that's the picture that was on the inside of that the poster thing. Okay. All right. So it wasn't actually the other guy. It's this Embersmith character here. Okay. All right. That's the second uncommon. The third uncommon is a Culling Dais, and our first rare and my first ever Scars of Mirrodin set of stuff is an actual rare. It looks like a land based upon the border, and it is a Blackcleave Cliffs. All right, so it looks like a dual land. Blackcleave Cliffs enters the battlefield tapped unless you control two or fewer other lands. add black or red to your mana pool. That's pretty cool. It's kind of like one of the old basic dual lands, especially if you get it on turn one or two. That's pretty good. I like that. Very nice. Not a huge fan of lands being in the rare category, but it's not that bad. Pretty cool. All right, and we have, we don't have a foil, it doesn't look like, but we do have a mountain. Interesting looking mountain. Wow, that's weird. All right. And then, what's behind that? A poison counter. Okay, that's interesting. Don't think I've ever actually seen an actual counter for poison. Okay, cool. All right. So, generally speaking, again, if you've never seen me open packs of Magic before, what I do is I tend to put them back into the packaging. That way, they stay nice and crisp and clean until I get to the point where I'm actually going to sort them into alphabetical order and then put them into a binder. So, I'll just leave them in the packaging, set the package to the side, and move on to pack number two. Alright. So, let's see if I can get this one open. I'm going to have to go to the bottom on this one, too, I think. Well, shucks. Alright, so I guess maybe the bottoms of these packages are a little easier to get through. I don't know. How strange. Alright. That's one of the reasons I'm not ripping into the packs, is because I use the packaging again. But, come on. Open up. If I could just get a finger. There we go. Okay. Alright, turn to slag. Wow, that's really neat looking. It's like a goblin that's melting or something. Wow, that's crazy, man. Wow, okay. Turn to slag. Ichorclaw Mirror. Grasp of Darkness. Let's see here. Wow, it's like a mechanical angel. Very strange. Okay. Alright. And then Corpse Cur. Scrap Diver Serpent. Soul Parry. Okay. Panic Spell Bomb. Didn't we have another Spell Bomb in the last one? I think we did. That artistic style of something in the corner like that reminds me of something. I think we have one that was over here in the last one. Izuri's Archers. That's a beautiful piece of art right there. Wow, that's gorgeous. Really, really well done. Relic Putrescence. There's a word that you don't hear too frequently. Any form of the word putrid. How frequently do we use that word? Very rare. Very rare. Horizon Spell Bomb. Okay, so yeah, this is apparently each one of these spell bombs is going to be a set. They're going to be like maybe in different corners of the thing. I wonder. No, they're not. I was thinking maybe they're in the order they are here on the back of the card. But no, this is the green one, so it would be down here if it were in that order. But it's not. That's okay. All right, a Dark Steel Axe. It's pretty. I like that. That's our first uncommon, by the way. Ichor Rats. I've heard about this mechanic called Infect. This creature deals damage to creatures in the form of -1/-1 counters and to players in the form of poison counters. When Ichor Rats enters the battlefield, each player gets a poison counter. That's kind of cool. I like that. That's a neat mechanic. I've not seen that. I've heard of it, but I've never actually seen a card with it on there. Dark Steel Sentinel. Wow, that's neat looking. It's a big looking dude, too. I love the little bits of glowing fire that are inside the guy. It reminds me of that, the last enemy in the original Thor movie where you could, like, it's like a furnace inside of the guy. Alright, so our next rare is going to be a Steel Hellkite. Alright, so for 6 mana, we get a 5/5 dragon. Flies, for 2 mana, Steel Hellkite gets +1/+1 until end of turn. And for X mana, destroy each non-land permanent with converted mana cost X, whose controller was dealt combat damage by Steel Hellkite this turn. Activate this ability only once each turn. That's pretty darn cool. I like that. That's really nice. Man, that's cool. And it looks like we've only got two cards behind this, so we shouldn't have a foil. That's a swamp. That's a kind of an icky-looking swamp. Some of these lands and things in the current Magic set, I'm not really... Well, that's not really a current Magic set. A lot of them, especially the swamps, don't look like what they're supposed to be. You know, I remember getting into Magic back in, you know, the revised 4th edition era, and everything looked like what it was supposed to. This kind of looks like just a blighted mountain in some cases. There's no real swampiness going on here. So, I don't know, I understand the concept that it's like a putrid, you know, fetid area, but it still doesn't look like a swamp. That's okay, though. Rules tip. That's interesting. So you get no, there's no token here, but there's a tip card. And apparently there's at least 5 of these, because this is tip number 1 of 5. Okay. All right. Give me something else to collect, I suppose. All right. Really like that. That's a beautiful piece of art, though. I love that. Who did that one? Oh, Zoltan Boros. It's one of my favorite current Magic artists. And Gabor Zixi? That's a strange name. Zixi, maybe. All right. Really, really nice, though. Okay. Love the artwork. Come on, go into the pack, please. Thank you very much. Appreciate your assistance. All right. Now, let's get back into this one here. I'm going to start on the bottom one this time. There we go. That mostly worked. Mostly. Alright, so, next, let's see what we've got in pack number 3. We have another Sky Eel School. Alright. Hope the glare is not killing these things. I keep forgetting that I can't tilt the cards too much. I apologize for that, by the way, if the glare is getting you. Silver Mirror. Ah, Blight Mamba. Wow, that's a creepy-looking snake. Regenerate Blight Mamba. Okay. All right, another infect creature. Nicely done, though. Really, really well done. Carapace Forger. Okay. Metalcraft. There's a mechanic I've not seen before. Carapace Forger gets +2/+2 as long as you control 3 or more artifacts. Okay, that's cool. All right. Silvok Life Staff. Okay. Bleak Coven Vampires. Also Metalcraft. Bleak Coven Vampires enters the battlefield. If you control 3 or more artifacts, target player loses 4 life and you gain 4 life. So Metalcraft must mean anything with 3 or more artifacts in play on your side gives you some sort of ability. I was wondering, okay, so this number 3 must be, I'm thinking, obviously just seeing 2 of the cards, must be a static number. It's probably not, like, on some of these, it's two pieces of artifact, or some of them maybe 4. Scoria Elemental. Is it Scoria or Scoria? Probably Scoria. Okay. Bladed Pinions. Really, really beautiful piece of art there. You don't see pink used that frequently, and you really don't see pink and gold combined all that frequently in art. But that's really well done. Untamed Might. Screeching Silcaw. Isn't this like a Howl from Beyond? I just thought about that. But I think Howl from Beyond does maybe plus X, minus X, or just plus X, plus O. I can't remember. Been a long time since I've seen a Howl from Beyond. Okay, Metalcraft again. Is it 3 artifacts? Yeah. Okay, so it's 3 or more artifacts, so that's pretty good confirmation there. Alright, so our first uncommon is a Flesh Allergy, followed by a Heavy Arbalest, and then a Rusted Relic, and then our rare is going to be, what's it going to be? True Conviction. Alright, so it's an enchantment for 3 white and 3 colorless. Creatures you control have double strike and lifelink. I like the effect. It seems a little expensive at that casting cost, but it's pretty nice. Alright, and then we've got a Plains. Again, not really looking like a Plains, just sort of looking like a very up-close version of a wheat field. And then, here's an actual token, a mirror token. Really cool. I like the stony kind of effect of this guy. That's neat. All right. That's really well done. Ryan Pancoast is the artist on that one. Very, very beautiful. Okay. Who's that? I have no idea. There's another piece of artwork from somewhere. Really neat looking, too. All right, so let me get this pack put away. And it looks like we've got five more to go. And I appreciate you sticking around, by the way, first of all. You're still here, at least. I know I'm kind of a slow pack opener, especially when it's something new that I've never done before. I just enjoy the cards, you know. I enjoy the process of getting into the packs. I enjoy the artwork on the cards. And, you know, I used to be one of those people, when I first got back into Magic, I would just tear through a pack and go straight to the rare and just see if I'd made my money back. But truth be told, I just like the experience, you know. It's kind of like, it's almost like going to a movie for me, you know. Expensive movie, obviously, but, you know, the longer that I get to take and the longer I get to enjoy it, just creates memories of, you know, hey, remember when I opened that particular card? And for me, this is the first time I'm opening Scars and Mirrodin and stuff, so for me, it's kind of a nice little experience to have, and a nice memory that I'll get to have. And I'm filming it, so I get to have that memory forever. I can just go back and watch this again. Alright, so Blade Tribe Berserkers. Silvok Replica. I love the armor on that thing. That is really nicely done. Fume Spitter. Wow, that reminds me of like an old Drew Tucker drawing almost. Carapace Forger again. Contagious Nim. A lot of colors used in this thing. A huge array of colors. Wow. Strider Harness. Alpha Tyrannix. Withstand Death. Wall of Tanglecord. White Sun's Passage. And our first uncommon is the Necrogen Scudder. Followed by the Trigon of Rage. I'm betting, if I had to put money on it, I'm betting that this is one of those things that's actually a set of five, one for every color. Could be wrong, but I'm betting that's the case. The Barrage Ogre. I like that. That is so cool. Man, I love the teeth on that guy. It's insane. That is absolutely fantastic. Oh, wow, what a great piece of art. All right, so let's take a look at that rare. What's it going to be? It's going to be, look, it's another land. What is it? Another Blackcleave Cliffs. All right, so we've already read it once, but I'll read it again. Blackcleave Cliffs enters the battlefield tapped unless you control two or fewer other lands. Add black or red to your mana pool. All right, still the same coolness level as last time. All right, and then we have a forest, which actually kind of looks like a forest in some respects, I suppose. And then another rules tip. This one's for Metalcraft, so this is number 2 out of 5. All right, cool. Very, very nice. All right. That's interesting, too. The first pack I opened was the Elspeth. It had a Blackcleave Cliffs in it. And the fourth pack I opened was an Elspeth, and it had a Blackcleave Cliffs in it. What are the odds that Elspeth number 3 will have a Blackcleave Cliffs in it? All right. Go ahead.
Go back into your home.
There we go. Okay. 4 more. Let's see here. These packs are really kind of dinged up on the bottom. The cards seem okay, though. I think it's just from being left in that fat pack box for years and years and years. When were these made? This was, I think, the set before I got back into Magic. Let's see. When was this? Oh, 2010. No, this is way before then, because I got back in my first couple of packs when I first got back into Magic after taking a huge break since, I think, like, Weatherlight Stronghold was, I think, Avacyn Restored, and then, but the only reason I bought those was because, Return to Ravnica had been out for a while. I think Dragon's Maze was the newest set, and Theros was coming out, and my local game store was basically out of Avacyn Restored. Not, you know, I'm one of those people that's like sort of a contrarian. You know, everybody buys the newest and greatest stuff, and I'm like, you know what? You only got like 4 packs of that old thing. Let me have that old thing. I like the sound of it. So I guess really closer to Theros is when I really got back into Magic. But anyway, Glint Hawk Idol, Flameborn Hellion, Silvok Replica, Perilous Mirror. Oh, that's cute. That is awesome. It's like a robotic turtle with a stork or a toucan's beak. That's cute. I like that one. That's one of my favorite pieces that we've seen so far. Really nice. Bleak Coven Vampires. Izuri's Archers. Relic Putrescence. Horizon Spellbomb. Assault Strobe. That's a big dude in the background. Target creature gains double strike. Okay. Let's see. Vector Asp. Trigon of Corruption. Hey, I told you guys. I knew it. First uncommon there. Second uncommon is the Embersmith. Third uncommon is a Culling Deus. And our rare for this pack is a Sunblast Angel. It's a 4/5 angel, costs 2 white and 4 colorless. It flies, obviously. And when Sunblast Angel enters the battlefield, destroy all tapped creatures. Alright, that's not too bad. Be nice if you could flash it in and do it on your opponent's turn, but hey, it's not bad. And I don't think we have a foil here, so there's a mountain. That kind of looks like a mountain. It's mountainous. And another poison counter. Alright. Hey, there's a cool another one. Another cool piece of artwork. Very nice. Alright. Okay, so let's put this one away. By the way, if I'm pulling anything cool, please feel free to tell me in the comment section. I mean, I'm probably going to at some point, when I edit this video, maybe go back and look up some of the value of some of these things or see if they're any good. But like I said, for the most part, this is an art experience for me, and it's just a fun... I just love opening packs. I don't know what it is. You give me a pack of just about anything, I'll open it up and enjoy myself doing it. All right. That one did not open well on the side. That's okay. Hey, there's something we haven't seen, and it's a common, too. Moriok Reaver. That's freaky. Man, that dude's got, like, a sickle attached to his hand. Thought he was holding it there at first, but it's, like, growing into his hand. Creepy. Galma's Warden. Chromesteed. Saw that before. Carapace Forger. Stoic Rebuttal. Loxodon Wayfarer. Wing Puncture. Steady Progress. Really beautiful contrast there of the cool colors and the dark and the warm colors between the blue and the red. Really just that hint of red right there and a little bit of a hint of red inside the purple and the cloaks. Very, very well done. Great piece of art right there. Ooh, there's a mechanic too I haven't seen. Proliferate. You choose any number of permanents and or players with counters on them, then give each another counter of a kind already there. Okay, well that's pretty cool. Alright, so another Horizon Spellbomb. I think that's 3 or 4 of those by now. Arc Trail is our first uncommon, followed by the Auriac Edgerite. That's a mouthful. Auriac Edgerite. And then another Culling Deus. Our rare in this pack is going to be a Strata Scythe. 3 mana gives us an equipment artifact with imprint. All right, so what's this do? When Strata Scythe enters the battlefield, search your library for a land card, exile it, then shuffle your library. Equipped creature gets +1/+1 for each land on the battlefield with the same name as exiled card. That's pretty cool. I like that. Very, very nice. And there's 3 cards behind here, which means that we have probably a foil card behind this. So let's see, what foil is it going to be? Well, no, I guess it's not. Unless they put the foil in a different position. There's an island. What's behind the island? A mirror token. What's behind the mirror token? There is a foil. They just put it in the very back slot. I'm not used to seeing that. What is it going to be? A Liquimetal Coating. That's a foily card right there. Very foily. What's this do? 2 mana for an artifact. Target permanent, tap target permanent becomes an artifact in addition to its other types until end of turn. Okay, I don't know why you would want to do that. Maybe it was something that you could do in a mechanic in this set. I guess it would help with that metal craft. That'd be cool. Okay, so you could basically have this on the field and tap this to turn one of your creatures into an artifact or some kind of permanent into an artifact and give you a second artifact for that metal craft. Okay, all right. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to do something weird here. I'm actually going to take this and swap positions with that mirror. That way the mirror protects the foil card. And then we're going to slip it back into the package, like so, kind of. If we can get it into the package, please go back into the package.
Go into the home!
There we go. Sometimes you have to be aggressive. Next to the last one. Two more to go. That would kind of be the same thing, Christopher. Next to the last. Two more to go. I might as well say it's the penultimate pack while we're at it. Let's see what's in this one. An Iron Mirror. Kimba's Sky Guard. It's good to see some cards we haven't seen yet. Bonds of Quicksilver. A Gold Mirror. Molder Beast. Revoke Existence. That's basically a... it's like a disenchant, but it's even better because it exiles them instead of just puts them in the graveyard. Cool. Sylvok Lifestaff. Tumble Magnet. That's an interesting item. Tumble Magnet enters the counter field with three charge counters on it. Remove charge counter, tap target artifact or creature. Doesn't really do a whole lot, but hey, it's kind of neat looking. A Blister Grub. It's kind of like an ugly version of that cute little mirror that we saw a little while ago. Razor Field Thresher. First uncommon is the Twisted Image, followed by another Rusted Relic. I remember seeing that a while back. And then a Tangle Angler. All right, I like that. That's neat. It's like a an anglerfish, but apparently one on land. All right, so I've got three cards behind this, which means we have a rare and then probably no foil. Let's see what the rare is going to... Ooh, it's a mythic! It's a mythic! That's a red. What's this going to be? A Mind Slaver. All right, so this is 6 mana for a legendary artifact. 4 mana and a tap. Sacrifice Mind Slaver. You control target player during that player's next turn. That's kind of interesting. Okay. Alright, I like that. We also have a mountain. And we got a goblin. Hey, that's cool. We haven't seen one of these yet. Goblin token with a very small little loincloth. Alright. Neat. Alright. So, let's put this one away. Well, we finally picked out a mythic. Alright, took 7 packs to do it. So that's pretty cool. Alright. Last Elspeth. Are we going to find that same land in our rare slot in this one? Oh, I got to open it from the bottom because the tops don't seem to want open on these things. Come on, open up. Open sesame. All right. There we go. So let's see what our final pack of the Scars of Mirrodin Fat Pack holds. A Lumengrid Drake. Ferrovor. A Silver Mirror, Sylvok Lifestaff, Bleak Coven Vampires, Tainted Strike, awesome looking dude right there. I think that was one of the pictures that was inside that poster as well, if I remember right. I kind of remember seeing that face. Seize the Initiative, Untamed Might, Bladed Pinions, Oxida Daredevil, is that a goblin? It looks like a goblin, it is. Sacrifice an artifact. Oxide Daredevil gains haste until end of turn. That really only works once. All right. Aha, we're in the uncommon. Skin Render. Second uncommon is another Rusted Relic. If it's another Deus, I think we'll have a playset. Let's see what's it going to be. It's not a Deus. It's another Tangle Angler. And behind this we have what looks like 3 cards, I think? Yep, just 3. So let's see what is our final rare in this set. It's green. It's rare. It's aestheticism. Is that right? Aestheticism. Weird. Okay. Aestheticism. I've never heard that word used in that manner before. I've heard aesthetic, but whatever. Enchantment. For 2 green and 3 colorless, Creatures you control can't be the targets of spells or abilities your opponents control. That's very cool. I like that. Very, very nice. And let's see, behind that we have a forest, and then we have another poison counter. All right. So, very, very neat, neat set of booster packs. I think I ended up, I want to say I paid like $35 for this thing. I found it on eBay when I was looking for something else. I had no idea whether I got my money back or not, but I did get to start a brand new set that I will work towards completing at some point anyway. So I'll end up buying a booster box of this at some point, and we'll crack some more of these open. But I wanted to do this tonight and just enjoy myself and have a good time. And I hope that you guys had a good time as well. If you have any comments or questions, and I certainly hope that you do, feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions so you don't miss any of these awesome videos. I want to thank you once again for watching. It really means a lot to me. And that's all I got for you guys today. So, thank you once again. God bless you all. Have a phenomenal rest of the day. And I will see you all in the next video.